وصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل إن كنتم تحبون الله فاتبعوني يحببكم الله ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم والله غفور رحيم وقال سبحانه إن الله ملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام كل أمتي يدخلون الجنة إلا من أبى قيل ومن أبى يا رسول الله قال من أتاني دخل الجنة ومن أصاني فقد أبى. All praise and thanks is to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, most gracious, most merciful Allah, who is the only one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who got no partner, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala got no child. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is there when there was nothing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be there when there will be nothing also. هو الأول ليس قبله شيء هو الآخر ليس بعده شيء. That is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is Malikul Mulk, King of all the kings also. تُؤْتِ الْمُلْكَ مَنْ تَشَاءَ. Allah gave the kingdom to any person whom he wish also. وَتُعِزُّ مَنْ تَشَاءَ. Respect, honor, dignity is all from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah give honor, when Allah give respect, when Allah give you dignity, no person on the earth can take that from you and bring shame on you. وَتُذِلُّ مَنْ تَشَاءَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also disgrace. Allah lowered you, Allah disgrace a person. When everybody put together, they can put their hands together to lift that person up. Because Allah's disgrace is upon him, no one can lift that person up also. بيد الخير. Every good is from Allah and is in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. تولج الليل في النهار. Day and night also is changed by Allah alone. تولج الليل في النهار وتولج النهار في الليل. And we can see now it's light, but tomorrow, just in the evening, we'll see the darkness coming. Without any sound, we don't feel nothing, but Allah is just changing this. إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ. Allah's power is above all powers. So that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who selected Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he made the best of all human beings and the best of all character compared to all human beings. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose him the best, and Allah tell us that if you follow that person and know how much I love that person and know how much you will be successful if you have to follow the way of that person. Remember the verse I recited, Allah is tu'izzu man tasha wa tudhillu man tasha. Now people put together, they need some consultation, they have to put somebody into a certain position. How much happy will be that person? Because you see certain personalities, they came there. These are big guys from this place, they from that, they from that. And they selected this person, they chosen him. Everyone is aware of him. That is thousands or millions of people. But this Nabi of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loved him so much. Billions of people, it can come on the day of Qiyamah, we will be the witness of those nations before, because their kisa is mentioned in the Quran. Allah has mentioned their stories in the Quran. We have not the past. So when the Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam, they came on the day of Qiyamah in the platform of Qiyamah, they will say that no, nobody came to us, nobody remind us this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Prophet will say, you can ask the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So his Ummah will be witnessing those people. We are the last Ummah who came on this earth. But Allah gives the privilege to this Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they will be the first to enter into Jannah. So Allah is the one who selected him and put him into that position. Who is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Allah mentioned in the Quran most of the time. When you can see in many places of the Quran, Allah is calling many of the prophets by their names, Ya Isa ibn Maryam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Yahya khudul kitab bi quwwa, Ya Musa, Ya Harun, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning them like that. You got a child, you got this child, you call him Muhammad, my beloved Musa, you call him with affectionate name. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is calling Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in different title of the Quran. That is the position Allah ta'ala have given him. Ya ayyuhal muddassir, ya ayyuhal muzammil, ya ayyuhal nabi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala call him, oh my beloved nabi of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the one who wrapped himself in an envelope, covering himself with the blanket. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he loved him so much that Banu Tamim, the tribe of Tamim, one day came to one place where there is a lot of apartments. They're looking for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So there is some sahaba with them also. So they don't know where is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which room he was. Now somebody said, you know what, let us call his name, Ya Muhammad Ukhrij Ilayna. Oh Muhammad, come out, we want to meet you, we want to see you. The same time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the verse of the Quran with Jibreel alayhi salatu wa salam, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُنَادُونَكَ مِنْ وَرَاءِ الْحُجُرَاتِ. Oh, those people, you the people who are calling my Nabi by his name like that. أَكْثَرُهُمْ لَا يَعْقِلُونَ. Most of you doesn't have senses on that to call my Nabi just like that on his name. وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ صَبَرُوا لَكَانَ خَيْرًا. If these people have to wait a little bit and wait for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this was better for them. Why are you calling my Nabi by his name just like that? The ayat I recited before you, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Salamun ala Ibrahim, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent salam to Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa sallam. Salamun ala Ilyasin. Allah sent salam to previous Ambiya alayhi salatu wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself ordered this ummah, Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Not only me, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and my malaika, I am putting the malaika on top of it also. So you believers, ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, or you who believe, sallu alayhi, you also send salat to Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So this prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, have mentioned him, not part of the Quran, by titles. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chosen him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala selected him. Today subhanahu wa ta'ala only knows how many of us today we are following that tariqah and that lifestyle of that Rasul of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How much lifestyle we have selected, different from his lifestyle. He has chosen the right, the guy who said, I choose the left. Why? وَلَنْ تَرْضَىٰ أَنْكَ الْيَهُودِ وَلَنْ نَصَارَىٰ حَتَّىٰ تَتَّبِعَ مِلَّتَهُمْ. You will find this Yahud ways, you will find this Nasara ways. The men should then know this is the best of all lifestyle because it's an enjoyment of this world, yes. You enjoy out of it in dunya. But what is the enjoyment of dunya compared to the enjoyment of akhir? وَمَنْ حَيَاتُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا مَتَاعُ الْغُرُورِ. This dunya, everything of it is deception. We see a lot of things, they become old 60 years ago, 70 years ago. Today, those things, people don't look at them. We're looking at the latest things. Jannah is forever. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put those people in Jannah, they will be there forever. Enjoying is everlasting. But dunya, everything is temporary. But that lifestyle and the lifestyle of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they are completely different. Allah chose that life for us. If we have to follow it, we will be successful not only in dunya, but in akhirah also. Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhu, they follow Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in every step. One day Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu, this one have to make some mistake. They have to give him some lashes. So when they are hitting the child, subhanallah, until the last beating, the child told the father, you know what, daddy, if you hit me this time, if you give me these lashes, I will be collapsed, I will be no more. He said, oh my son, you know what? If you go on, you are no more. The Muslim Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the same religion he have left behind, the same religion Umar bin Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu is carrying on. When he was entering into Palestine, he was taking the keys. Muslims took over Palestine. What happened? They saw Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu coming with some clothes which are patched. Sahaba came to him, oh Umar bin Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu, you know what? Can you please change these clothes? You let us put on new clothes for you, please. We're going to meet senior people. We're going to meet high class people. Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu take a sand and throw it on top of this one. Because of what? Kunna adalla qawm. We were those nations before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We were not guided. We were not guided people. We kill our daughters alive. We bury them alive. We do a lot of things. A'azzana Allahu bil Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He have raised us because of Islam and the way Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam have came to us with that perfect religion. That is what we are following. Allah loves that Nabi. Allah Ta'ala loves that Prophet of Him. Anytime Allah mentions His name in the Quran, today we say, no, it's only Sunnah. It's only nothing. If you do this, you do that. No, there is nothing. Just carry on with the Quran. Who saw us the wudu? إِذَا كُنْتُمْ إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ فَاغْسِلُوا وُجُوهَكُمْ وَأَيْدِيَكُمْ إِلَى الْمَرَافِقِ وَانْصَحُوا بِرُؤُوسِكُمْ وَأَرْجُلَكُمْ إِلَى الْكَعْبَيْنِ. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala means we have to wash our faces and we have to wash our hands to our elbows. We have to make masah. We have to wash our feet. How do we wash our feet? How do we wash our face? How do you make that masah? How do you wash your feet? Who came to show us this? Who gave us that light and that direction? Allah tells us to perform that salah. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came with the perfect way to perform that salah. When a sahabi came, he was performing salah. He said, go and pray. You never pray. He performed two rakat in front of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with such a speed and all that, mashallah, in hurry to finish that salah, to complete that salah. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, go and pray. Because you have never prayed. Salah is not that, subhanAllah. Allah gives the qualities of the people of Jannah al-Firdaws. We learn from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam how he performed that salah. Sallu kama ra'aytumuni usalli. Pray as how you see me praying. We never saw Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but our knowledgeable ulama, they have taught us the way of that salah. When we have to perform it that way, we will be successful. Allah Ta'ala gives the good qualities of those people in Jannah al-Firdaws. الَّذِينَ هُمْ عَلَىٰ صَلَوَاتِهِمْ يُحَافِظُونَ. Those who memorizes their salah, they do their salah in accordingly with khushu. قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ. Those who make their salah in a proper way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted, with contentment, with khushu, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how He wanted. If we don't know it, ask that person who is next to you, that imam, that maulana, that sheikh, hey, how did I perform my salah? Is this the correct way to perform my salah? أول ما يحسب يوم القيامة. First thing Allah will ask us on the day of Qiyamah, that salah. Imagine you read your salah for 60 years, 50 years, 30 years. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, on the day of Qiyamah, He call you. They say that there is nothing for you here. How we perform in that salah? It's our ruku is completed. How much farad is in that salah? If I leave that farad, if I leave that sunnah, what is this? What will happen? We should know this thing that will get us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is where to follow Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in every footstep. If we have to do it how He taught us, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make us successful. To rather say no, it's just a sunnah. In performing that sunnah salah, what is that nafil salah? In the day of Qiyamah, if that Salah or Faraid got some errors, that is where they put this, all this Nafil and that Sunnah Salah, they will put it under it to correct that Farad of yours. So now no time for that Sunnah, no time for that Nafil, no time for that, no time for that. These are all Sunnah, let's go straight to the Quran. Quran teach us, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ If you love me, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَاتَّبِعُونِي Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tell them they must follow you, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهِ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will love you. Allah will put you in a high position on the day of Qiyamah because you are following that step of His beloved Nabi يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهِ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ We all know كُلُّ بَنِي آدَمَ خَطَعُمْ We all commit sin وَقَيْلُ خَطَعِنَا تَوَابُونَ All those who make tawbah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said those people are the best. So وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make sure that He forgive your sins by following that Nabi. وَاللَّهُ غَفُورُ رَحِيمُ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala He have given us that opportunity. Allah said, I am Ghafoor Rahim. So follow that guidance. Follow that lifestyle. Look at the akhlaq of Rasulullah ﷺ. Look at the behavior of him. Even his work, you can learn from it. When a noble person is passing, or a great person is passing, now surrounded by a lot of people, sometimes temptation can take him, he can overlap and start walking in different ways to show that no, how they're promoting him. He is so and so, he is so and so. He become high, so he forget. But look at Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he's sitting with his sahaba radiallahu anhu. If you don't know him, you will not say that this is Nabi of Allah. This is how he lowered himself. If you heard of him, you want to meet him. Those people who meet him immediately, subhanAllah, they start loving him. By the gaze and the face of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But today, how many sunnah we want to follow, and how much we said, no, I'll leave it out. It's just a sunnah. I mean, here today, Muslim will say, it's just a sunnah. Allahu Akbar. How much sacrifice you have to make for this today, we are Muslims. Allah gave him a big position on the day of Qiyamah. No one is allowed to enter into Jannah without Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam first opening the door of Jannah. So today to degrade that sunnah of that personality is nothing in the eyes of that person who is a Muslim. He will rather count himself in another way than to count himself in the lifestyle of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now these ones are low class people, those who follow his steps and all that. And these are the high class people, so called. Allah has selected us, Allah has chosen us to be in that ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We are the one to show that sunnah to everyone, to show to the people, not to tell anyone. Not to tell them that, no, you are a Muslim. But your actions show the person, show the people that you are a Muslim. Let your actions show that you are a Muslim. Let your personality show that you are a Muslim. Let your appearance show that you are a Muslim. It can give attraction to somebody you don't know. Allah gives hidayat in different ways. Who knows? Allah gives hidayah in different ways. We don't know where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will count you by performing one sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. By performing, it can give hidayah to somebody next to you. A person heard azan, who is not a Muslim. He heard Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. And he's hearing between them, Muhammadur Rasulullah, Ashhadu an la ilaha ashhadu anna Muhammadur Rasulullah. So when he heard this, subhanAllah, he came closer to the masjid, where they call it this azan. You have to get next to a person
Who told him, who is that personality they are calling? Ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. Because he had Muhammad, Muhammad, Muhammad. But now it's read in the loud voice where people are calling in Muslim countries. Many places, mashallah. Here also you can hear us loudly in many places. So when they explain to him who is this person, who is the personality of this person, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loved him, many parts of the Quran, if Allah is mentioning his name, is mentioning Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam there, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him position on the day of Qiyamah. Only that Azan by mentioning in Adhan gave hidayah to that person. Addressing of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. A person verse, just here, in Victoria town. This young group of people wearing white, mashallah, they pass in front of a person, he's working. So he left the job quickly, he came to the brothers, you know what? I like this church of yours, he called it. I like these dressings, I like this way, I like this lifestyle. The brothers mentioned to him, okay, mashallah, no problem, this is how you join it, this is how you come to close to it. He said, that's all. He said, they tell him, yes, very simple and easy. You don't have to pay fees, you don't have to do that, you don't have to do that. They make him to recite the kalima, subhanAllah. The brother is so happy that Allah, Allah, he's very happy to come to podium side and is getting some lesson of the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is what Allah brought us here in this dunya. We are passing to go to akhirah. So make that dunya to be easy going, to let akhirah to be everlasting life. But when we take it in other way, which is not the way of Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we will be disgraced first in dunya, and akhirah is the most disgraceful place where mistakes are not corrected. Whilst we can correct that mistake in dunya here, let us correct it. Wa akhiru da'wana. Alhamdulillah.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We at the Institute for Islamic Services are in the process of carrying out Operation Winter Warmth for 2014. We are still short of approximately 500 blankets, and each blanket costs 47 rand. If every person in the masjid gives us one blanket each, inshallah we will reach the total amount. We do appeal to people to support this cause. Jazakallah.